We each are on our own path and have our own missions. Some are activists, some help clear the masses of old energies, others share light, some light up folks' path, while others increase the love within and upon earth and all of life. There are many paths and missions in life. We each are unique in what we share, yet we are all one. Each shares in their own way, whether they are aware of it or not. Awareness is key, as when one is aware of what their mission is, it doesn't matter how they choose to share their light, just that they know they do so uniquely. One can be in what may appear to be a mundane job, yet if that being is in joy and passion, they are aware of what their mission is. One's mission is not some magical knowing, it is obvious to the aware one. It simply takes looking deeper with awareness in how they share their mission from their heart. An awakened one doesn't compare their mission with another, realizing that no mission is less or more than any other. We have all come far in our expression as souls and in our awakening to the divinity within. This month actually prepares us for next year, where there is more integrating of our divine selves. I see it as a transition month. We have done so much work clearing and integrating that if you journal how you've been in the past, you will not recognize that person. Of importance is to see how you have created endings in your life, so that you may begin anew. The answers to why lie deep below the surface. Dive below and discover the gift, for everything has a gift of awareness within it, no matter how tragic you perceive the surface event to be. As you discover the gift, be grateful, even while you grieve the loss of old life. There has been a tremendous letting go, which has resulted in a perceived separation from loved ones, as one scenario. Yet, all is in divine order. You can grieve if you have a belief in loss, yet ask yourself what loss really is. Is it an illusion? To me, it is illusion, for we do not lose anything. All is connected and things may change form, which affects one's life in a grand way. If you can see loss as a readjustment and gift for you, then your consciousness rises to the next level. In all situations, there comes a time to let go, so you can begin a new chapter in life. The more you resist this, the more difficult life becomes. Allow the flow of grace to carry you through perceived difficulties. Notice I use the word perceived, as all is based on one's own perception and is not necessarily truth. We are still releasing the ancient wound of separation. This can be seen being played out by many people, organizations, and governments. Much of the very distant past is also coming forth to be healed and healed. This includes people we have known and not known in history, saints, gurus, ancestors and entire belief systems. Focus on your mission without being distracted by so much duality. What you focus on is what is created and powerfully manifest. Gaia certainly is releasing a lot, yet it all is in divine order. Stay true to who you are without getting sucked down the rabbit hole. We are creating the new earth as we focus entirely on being love. Just as each of the animal kingdom has their own path, a big hawk just showed up as a confirmation, so do we. Each of us also may experience being very scattered as we traverse the old and the new. This goes for the folks around us as well. Be patient. The mind cannot quite get what the new is all about and there is a tendency to attach to the old, because it is familiar. Yet, we are further along in our desire to let go of the old, so focus on divine service, being in nature, meditating, and remind yourself that you are doing the very best you can. There is much activation of our new selves to calibrate ourselves to a new way of being. It's not like we're all alone in this, we are helped by engaging with the activations and by making conscious choices. Have complete faith that you are guided by your highest self, so be aware of all of what you are guided to do moment by moment. This guidance comes in the form of messages, both inner and outer, and by your own intuitional feeling. As we let go of the old, we may not know what to do next. Do not fret about this or analyze it. Stay in the now moment, from this place you will know what step to take next. We are like the caterpillar, who dissolves completely in the chrysalis, and in time, the butterfly is assembled in wholeness. It takes a while. After all, it has taken many lifetimes for us to create who we are and were, so be patient. We are emerging from our chrysalis as a new being of love, beautiful in our magnificence. I am not saying it will take many lifetimes to be completely new, unless that is your soul's choice. Stay in the now and put all of your focus on being love, on your path, on who you are becoming. Let go of the past and the future. Be here now. Let go of expectations about how it's supposed to be, and let go of any attachment you have to plans. In the new, there are no plans. There is only now. One of the best ways to anchor the new is to surrender. This isn't passive. As you surrender to what is with hard intentions, it is like you are on a river. Without a paddle, it's easy to get stuck in an eddy or on a rock or a branch. With a paddle, you become one with the flow. This is empowered movement. You are not helpless. You are not a victim of circumstance. You guide your boat. Surrender with intention to your preferred way of being. Consciously make a decision to be active in the flow of new life. This will help you align with the highest expression of love. Surrender is letting go and allowing. Surrendering with intention is aligning to your purpose and to the highest outcome. Surrendering is important, for you don't control or manage the flow, you become one with the flow. Let go of end results, allow your intention to be manifest by source. Your source. Because we're still releasing old emotions and energy, we will experience release in many ways. You may pee or sweat a lot. You are clearing not only old emotions, but the stuck toxins in your cells as well. We were all star seeds from other dimensions. We have agreed to take on a body. When we do that, we also step into any unfinished business of other lifetimes. We have agreed to not only bring forth a higher consciousness, but to also clear our bodies and planet of all that is not love. Being a star seed, you are probably very empathic and sensitive to energies. Through this clearing, we become even more sensitive and empathic, yet these all help us navigate the world through our intuition and awareness. From this place of high awareness, we make decisions that help to align us with our soul, an aspect of source. Aligning or emerging with soul increases our vibration, and thus, we are able to transform the old into the new. Meditation greatly helps with this, for meditation aligns us with our purpose and soul merging. Simply breathe divine source love and light into your heart, high heart, or pineal chakra. Bring this divinity throughout all your chakras and cells. You do this with intention and breath and visualization, if you are visual. We are anchoring our new blueprints, which helps us integrate and manifest our highest potential. As we do this, we move into a new experience physically. This is because our light bodies are more powerfully connected to our earth bodies as well as to the higher dimensions. This is soul merging. We will begin to walk the earth as ascended masters. What does being an ascended master in a human body on earth mean to you? Being an ascended master in human form means you take full responsibility for all your choices fully awake. You are not a victim of any circumstance. You are powerful as you stand in your own light and knowing. Of course, this is just one aspect of being an ascended master.